Hey guys, how's it going? Today I'm proud to present to you 2017 brand spanking new Chinese car Chery Tiggo 2. In this video I'm going to show you the interior as well as the exterior of this car. And so guys, here's the key. Let's start the engine, let it run for a while. Lock, unlock, control button, flip key. Also, this car comes equipped with the aftermarket alarm, of course, with a remote start. White exterior, beautiful color in my opinion. Chrome door handles. Absolutely stunning interior. Very light and at the same time wide opening doors. It's almost like 90 degrees, providing easy entry and exit. This car has two airbags. Seats and interior, cloth seats. Quite comfortable. Three-spoke design, fully wrapped steering wheel. Let's hop on in. Not bad. Five-speed manual. This portion is illuminated. Insert the key and then twist. Very nice startup. Very fluid steering wheel, horn, very loud, manual tilt only to adjust user's lever right there, chrome, stitched airbag cover, thick steering wheel, sport grips up top. Alright guys, right now let's send headlight, rear fog light, high beam, as well as headrest lights. Power windows, automatic down only, rear windows, back windows are fully tinted, your center lock, power window lock, very elegant door handles. Alright guys, right now let's open the hood and take a good look at the exterior of this car. Lever right there, let's open the hood, it's quite easy. This car doesn't have a power moonroof. Roof rails up top. Beautiful tail lights. Chrome. Rear defrosted glass, rear wiper. Your deck lid spoiler with LED third brake light. Rear fog lights, rear parking assist, LED license plate lights, and your rear view camera right there. Very nice body lines. Multi-spoke aluminum rims, 16-inch, tires measuring 12-5-55, front Bentley disc brakes and rear solid disc brakes. Beautiful factory rims. Alright guys, right now I'm going to show you underneath this beautiful car. LED turn signal kits and exterior mirrors, very bright. Your VIN number. intelligent project headlamps, Tigger. LED daytime running lights, chrome grille, huge cherry emblem, This car has inline 4, 16-valve, 1.5-liter, normally aspirated engine. It produces 106 horsepower and 135 Nm of torque. Maximum speed 190 km per hour. 0-60 time is 12.4 seconds. Combined fuel consumption for this car is around 7 liter per 100 km. The car is front-wheel drive and the fuel tank is around 50 liters. Independent McPherson thrust suspension with under roller up front and independent Moulton suspension out back. Alright guys, right now we take a good look at the exterior. Let's take a good look at the interior portion, the most interesting part. Fake carbon fiber trim, soft leather wrap armrest and fake aluminum trim. All your bar amenities, storage area and bottle holder, speakers, Tigger. Driver's seat, as manual adjustment, standard sliding right there and recline, and there is now seat height. Seats are quite comfortable, adjustable headrests and seatbelts. Of course, your tire pressure. Fuel cap release right here. Your armors for the carts, high headlights, fuse box located right there, your pedals, and onboard diagnostics. Carbon fiber trim right here. Alright guys, right now, let's see what kind of noise this beautiful engine produces. And it's quite unusual to see this needle for the tachometer and speedometer. Very quiet engine. Well, definitely not bad. And here's your light indicator controls, of course, chrome, and your intermittent wiper controls, including rear wiper. Not bad. Of course, you can raise and lower the volume, your different modes for this display. Slide button different track or slide button different station, right there. And your cruise control settings, just set the speed. It's quite easy. All right, guys, let's see what we got here. Your digital speedometer right there. E-brake, seatbelt warning, and low fuel. Tire pressure monitoring system. Your digital speedometer, speed warning, clock adjustment, average and current fuel economy. Right now it's not correct. Distance to empty range. That's pretty much it for this display. Overall, build quality and all the materials feels very nice. Hard touch, interesting vans. Of course, your infotainment screen. You can raise or lower the volume. Select between different band, FM station, right here, mute, brightness, close the screen, language, home style, sound adjustment, audio, balance, car info, time adjustment. As you can see, it's quite easy. Of course, your equalizer settings system, cloud to connect your smartphone, basically. It's quite easy with this system, no problem at all. Bluetooth settings, Bluetooth, streaming of audio, of course, USB, iPod, and telephone controls. And it's pretty much self-explanatory. All right, let's see how it sounds. Four speakers. For the stock system, sounds pretty good. Not bad in general. Down here you can find your very easy to use air conditioning, your fan speed control, air conditioning on and off, recycle settings, your temperature adjustment, different modes, face, knee, etc. Chrome. Air conditioning is ice cold. Rear defrost, your headlights, lights, four-way flashers as well. And of course heated seats, two stage for the driver and for the passenger, high and low. USB integration right there, plus power supply right there. Storage compartment for the driver. 5-speed manual, like clutch. Easy to shift, first, second, third, fourth, thief, and reverse. Rear view camera. Of course, with guidance lines. Very clear graphic. As you can see, not bad. Your ashtray, two convenient cup holders, storage area. Don't expect to find armrest in this car. Manual dim rear view mirror, map lights up top, full LED, very bright and smooth. Sun visors, vanity mirror, no illumination, car holder, and warning. Visibility in this car is not so good. At my 6'3" stature, these seats are very nice. Legroom is more than enough. Thigh support is pretty good. And shoulder room is okay. So you can see how much space is left in this car. Not bad. For its price, it's just a Chinese bargain. Four mirrors. All right. I'm gonna demonstrate here right now. They also heated, but there is no power folding function. In general, not bad. Sweet. Alright, guys, right now, let's shut her down. Let's grab the key and continue to restore. By the way, very good warranty for this car, of course, but resale value is not so good, surprisingly. And as you can see, your illumination at night, very cool. Sweet. And with my 6'3" stature, it's quite easy to get in and out. Feel cap release. Child safety locks right here. And materials to carry over. Two-tone, soft leather wrap armrest, carbon fiber trim, ISOFIX system, back seats is default, adjustable headrest of course, like so, it's quite easy, one hand operation. But my 6'3" stature is quite easy to get in and out. Alright guys, legroom for me is not an issue at all, as you can see, but my headroom is limited. Group handles up top, storage pockets, right there, huge sentinel, don't expect to find armrests in this car. Back visibility is not so good, you have rear view camera and of course rear parking assist. Very stylish cherry to interior. And there is no interior illumination. Alright guys, right now, let's check trunk space, shall we? Trunk is huge, your power cover, right there. Illumination. Of course, you are one inch angle, cargo dead ends, grocery backpacks, and down here you can find your spare tire, only donut, tools, and jack. Not bad in general. One convenient handle to close trunk lid, and of course, your VIN number. Your fuel cap. Quite spacious and comfortable rear seats. And of course, you can find same manual adjustment for the passenger seat. Glove box is not lockable, as you can see. Pretty deep, I believe, with illumination. And here's your manuals right there. So guys, in general, this car is really fun to drive. PEP engine. Thanks to brakes, of course, very interesting. Tight suspension. It's just what you expect from this Chery Tiggo 2. Nice looking Chinese car. Well guys, hope you enjoy my in-depth look at this 2017 Chery Tiggo 2. Thanks for watching and take care guys.